You got to look closely. I know we've got more over toward Watertown, but that's not really much of our concern at this point. If you look carefully right here, right along I-89 here, Route 7, we've got a little rain coming down from Georgia up to St. Albans, and then right along 36 over toward Fairfield. We're talking about super light stuff, everybody. And then back just north of Plattsburgh, maybe a couple of raindrops here and there. That's about it. We've got couple of raindrops around Santa Clara yet again, and a little more likely we've got a little more rain making it to the ground. Not far from Akwesasne here, just to the north, and it's going to make its way probably closer to Montreal than us, if it even stays together. Now that we've lost the daytime heating, all this stuff is going to wind down, and we end up with a very nice night for everybody instead of, well, just about everybody, which is the way it's been. It is 63 in Plattsburgh, 67 degrees. Right now, Burlington, Waterbury checking in with 60 degrees. A little bit cooler, Bennington at 57 degrees. Springfield, just 59 degrees. Let me show you what to expect over the next 12 hours or so. Temperatures are going to be coming down. Certainly for 99.8% of us, it's going to be dry out there. Low temperature, about 56, we're thinking. And then temps start to go up again during the day tomorrow. You'll see it in the morning. But the high tomorrow, only in the low 70s. It will turn out to be a little bit cooler than it was today. Kind of a snapshot of the Northeast. Really the only places we're finding rain where we just pointed out. Meanwhile, all eyes on what's going on down in the Gulf of Mexico. This is going to be interesting over the next few days, and not necessarily in a great way. Tropical Depression Harvey. This thing already made landfall over the Yucatan Peninsula. Looked like it may fall apart, but looks like it's strengthening again. Watch what this thing is projected to do. This coming from the National Hurricane Center. It's only moving at a couple of miles an hour right now, but it looks like it's going to try to make landfall late Friday into Saturday, right along the Gulf Coast in Texas. That's going to be potentially a big problem for places like Houston. Could be looking at upwards of 12 inches of rain, some isolated areas, maybe even more than that. So the potential for flooding is massive here. And it looks like it may become a tropical storm, if not a hurricane, before it makes landfall. But I think the big problem with this thing is going to be the rain. So we'll watch that for you. Sun and clouds, that's what we're expecting for us tomorrow. That's going to be the case throughout the day. Maybe an isolated shower in the afternoon. That's it. So futurecast goes like this. We will take you right through the overnight. We look fine. Here's the beginning of tomorrow. Mix of sun and clouds. Just that chance for an isolated afternoon shower. The likelihood is not great. Tomorrow night we clear out. I mean, a few clouds remaining. Then we do it again on Friday. Mix of sun and clouds. I mean, really the outside chance for an isolated shower that day. So that too we'll keep an eye on. Partly cloudy tonight, few showers still lingering, 56 degrees, that's it for a low. Here comes your tomorrow. Temperatures in the 60s, 70s, like 64 Saranac Lake, 72 degrees in Plattsburgh, mix of sun and clouds, isolated shower possible in the afternoon. Same thing in northern Vermont, 72 Burlington, 67 Warren, 70 degrees in St. Johnsbury. And I think we find all in all more sunshine to the south. Mostly sunny, we'll call it. Rutland checking in with 71 degrees. So watch the 72s on here. That isolated shower Thursday, then into Friday, mix of sun and clouds, 72 those days. Then mostly sunny over the weekend. Saturday, Sunday, 72, 72. A lot of sun Monday, 75, and then clouds mixing in Tuesday, Wednesday, and temperatures those days just a few degrees higher.